हेलो फ्रेंड्स, वेलकम बैक टू माय चैनल जावा एक्सपर्ट ट्यूटोरियल। सो गाइस, इन दिस वीडियो वी विल डिस्कस अबाउट पॉलीमॉर्फिज्म इन जावा। सो लेट्स स्टार्ट विथ व्हाट इज पॉलीमॉर्फिज्म। पॉलीमॉर्फिज्म इज वन कॉन्सेप्ट ऑफ उप्स प्रिंसिपल। द वर्ड पॉलीमॉर्फिज्म मीन्स हैविंग मैनी फॉर्म्स। Polymorphism is a concept by which we can perform a single action in different ways. For example, water. Water is available in three forms: liquid, solid, and gas. So this is polymorphism. Now let's see some real life example of polymorphism. The first one is a person. A person at the same time can have different characteristics, like a man at the same time is a father, a husband, an employee. So the same person possesses different behaviors in different situations. This is called polymorphism. And another example is shape. Shape is also available in various forms, like circle, triangle, rectangle, oval. So there are so many forms of shape. So this is polymorphism. Now types of polymorphism. There are two types of polymorphism. The first one is compile time polymorphism. Second is run time polymorphism. Let's see the compile time polymorphism. Whenever an object is bound with their functionality or methods at compile time, this is known as compile time polymorphism. At compile time, compiler knows which method to call by checking the method signature. So this is called compile time polymorphism or static or early binding. Compile time polymorphism is achieved through method overloading. So let's see the example of method overloading. Okay, so this is the example of method overloading. Method overloading means if a class contains more than one method with same name but different argument list is called method overloading. So here, as you can see, we have three methods of area, but the arguments are different. Here it will take one argument, it will take two argument, it will take three argument. Okay. So this is method overloading. And here we create the object of shape class and calling the method area and passing the arguments. When we run this code, then the output will be like this: circle, circle, and circle. That means all method will execute because we call all the methods. So this is the example of method overloading, and I also create a separate video on method overloading. Okay. So the next is runtime polymorphism. Whenever an object is bound with the functionality at runtime, this is known as runtime polymorphism. The runtime polymorphism can be achieved by method overriding. Java Virtual Machine determines the proper method to call at the runtime, not at the compile time. It is also called dynamic or late binding. Let's see the example of runtime polymorphism. Okay, so guys, this is the example of method overriding. Here we create two classes, shape1 and circle, and circle class extends shape1 class. That means the method which is available in shape1 class is also available in circle class. Okay. Now, as you can see, area method is defined inside shape1 class, and we override the area method inside circle class. Okay. Now, when we create the object of circle class by giving the reference of parent class. Okay. Step one is parent class and circle is child class. So, we are giving the reference of parent class and creating the object of child class. That means at runtime, child class method will be execute because we create the object of child class. So, this is method overriding. Okay. Now, when we run this code, the child class method will be execute. Okay. As you can see. So, this is method overriding. Okay, so thank you guys for watching this video. See you in the next video. Bye-bye. Take care.